So here we are then, less than an hour's drive from the city of Melbourne, and we are amongst the wildlife, the best wildlife that Australia has to offer. And I guess when you think of Australia, you think of all the varied wildlife, everything from spiders and snakes to the cute and cuddly ones, like the kangaroos and the koalas as well.
Yeah, and in fact, we are here at the sanctuary, and we have spotted one or two koalas around and about. They're quite interesting animals, aren't they?
Well, they're nocturnal.
They're nocturnal, so it's quite unusual to be able to see them, I think, in this environment. Also, they've got quite an interesting dietary habit, haven't they, as well?
Much like yourself.
Yeah, I mean, they get all of their moisture. They don't drink water. They get all of the moisture from eating eucalyptus leaves, which
4 kilos a day.
Yeah, and it takes them a long time to digest the food as well. So that's why they're quite, perceived to be quite lazy animals as well. Spend a lot of time hanging around in the trees, keeping in the shade, and digesting their food.
You want to know something I found out?
Go on.
Only we call them koala bears. Australians just call them koalas because they're not bears.
I didn't know that.
And we think they're cute. We think they're cuddly, but they have some pretty impressive claws, which is what they use, obviously, to hang on to the trees. And we can see one of our dear friends up there doing exactly that. But there is a serious side to the work that happens here, and it's not just being up close to the animals. They look after sick and injured animals as well, which is exactly where we're heading next as we head to the animal hospital. Okay, so let's get a better idea, a better understanding of exactly what happens at this amazing place. And one of the experts here is Dr. Shearlings. Good to see you.
Nice to see you too.
And who's our patient?
This is a Gippsland water dragon. He was found in Ringwood, and they're not supposed to be found in Ringwood, so we think he might have been an escaped pet or hitched a ride with someone.
And the unique thing about this is that we're kind of on show as well. While I'm talking to you now, there's a whole bunch of people kind of staring at us, which can that be a little off-putting when you're doing these operations?
No, you get used to it. And when you're concentrating on what you're doing, you sort of don't realise that they're there, and you sort of ignore the peering eyes, so you get used to it.
But very unique, though, for the general public to be so up close and personal to some of the operations that happen here. I mean, this is, I guess, quite unique for Australia, yeah?
Yeah, it is. It's unique on a world scale as well. Not only can people look through the glass windows to look at us, there's also cameras in the roof so they can see directly into the operation. And if we're using special tools like an endoscope or an ultrasound, we can actually hook it up and play that through the video so that people can actually, in effect, be inside the animal as well. So it's really unique.
Well, I'm going to leave Ben to finish messing around with the lizards, and I've got something I think is much more exciting now. A career-defining moment, you could say. Think about Michael Parkinson, that famous interview he did with Emu. Now I'm going to get to meet the real thing. And I'm pleased to say I'm joined by Russell, who's the curator of the sanctuary. Russell, nice to see you.
Good morning.
We are rather close to some very big, fearsome-looking birds, almost quite reptilian-looking, aren't they?
They are. They're actually Australia's largest bird, the second largest bird in the world, just behind the ostrich out of Africa. And they are very closely related to dinosaurs and reptiles, and so they do have a lot of similarities in their behavior with them.
One thing that's rather interesting, I think, about emus is it is the dads that do all the work, isn't it? They seem to look after the young.
They do. It's quite unique in the animal world that the female actually is the one that does the bolt and takes off and leaves the eggs for the dad to hatch and then raise those chicks up, which takes about 3 to 4 months.
Okay, well, should we see if we can get some of them over? You've got some of their favourite food here, haven't you?
Yes, it's a native caprosman. It's got a little red berry on there, which is quite sweet, and it's one of their favourite foods.
And is this a male or a female here we've got who's tucking in?
This is a male.
Excellent. Well, I think what we should do now is leave this one to finish having its lunch. It seems to be rather enjoying it. And say thank you very much, Russell.
Thank you.
So it's incredible to see how up close and personal you can get to the animals here.
Yes, it is. And
a city slicker.
Quite literally so. Ooh. Yes, you might have noticed we're with some rather some rather familiar looking animals. These, of course, are kangaroos. And they're currently enjoying eating some corn, I think it is, and some carrot off my hand.
You're such a natural at this. You are like the Ace Ventura of Absolute Radio.
They actually, I've got to say, they're scratching me a little bit. And they've got really sharp claws, haven't they? You're keeping well away.
I am, because
from
I'm
these
not,
animals.
I've seen films, kangaroos can kick, my friend. but this is incredible. And I suppose the unique thing is just how close the general public can get to these animals. This one's coming up quite
Whoa. Fast. But we have an expert here with us today who I think is going to tell us a little
and
bit
we
more.
We need one, let's be
Come
honest.
On over. Hi guys, what's your name?
My name's Sue.
Sue, and just tell us a little bit about the animals then. I mean, they seem quite placid at the moment, but they've got very sharp claws, haven't they?
They do, but the sharp claws are there for digging, not for having a go at you guys, more for digging at the ground. So they're quite safe. They're only after the food. They're only vegetarians. They're not after your fingers. So yeah.
What is the collective term for a congregation of kangaroos?
We've got a small little mob in front of us at the moment. So
a mob.
Yeah, a mob.
And is the idea that these kangaroos will then go back out into the wild? Is that?
No, these guys have been born in captivity and they're a captive population, so they'll stay here. I don't know if they'd do all that well out in the wild because they're used to being hand-fed every day, so we make sure that they're well looked after here.
This one's rather enjoying the microphone.
Yes, she is. I think she's wanting to say something.
So there we are. We've had an amazing time at the Healesville Sanctuary and we really have seen some brilliant animals today.
Yeah, and I guess the unique thing about this place is all the animals we've seen today, from the lizards to the koalas to the kangaroos, they're all, you know, in the wildlife. So if you're here and you're driving back to the main city centre, just an hour away, less than an hour away, keep an eye out in the Yarra Valley because all these creatures, well, they're obviously native to Australia.